Very much.
The age-old city of Oxford, England. Here in 1954, at the Iffley Road track, a young medical student named Roger Bannister made history. Cool, wet, and windy weather promised slow times in the mile run. For 9 years, the mile mark had stood at 4:01.4. Man seemed to have reached his limit, and there was little reason to think the record would fall on this day. But Roger Bannister ignored the chill crosswind and the limits of human endurance. He put on a tremendous burst of speed over the final quarter mile. And that closing kick made him the first human to hurtle through the 4-minute mile barrier. Bannister's time was 3:59.4. Many have done it since, as many have reached the moon. But Roger Bannister was the first.
I give you the toast of Roger Bannister, the man whose record can never be beaten, the first man to run a 4-minute mile.
The unassuming Bannister became a living legend.
Any of you forget in this room that you are in the presence of an immortal.
Roger Bannister, the young medical student, went on to become one of Britain's most prominent physicians. He would never forget those glorious days on the track.
I don't know what inspires young men to do these things. It's simply the knowledge that there is a certain ability which should be allowed its full expression. For some people, taking a few steps on a running track, a sheer agony. For me, running had always been a kind of joy.
The joy of holding the mile record was short-lived for Bannister. Australian John Landy broke Roger's record just a few weeks after he set it. And then, the two greatest milers in the world faced off at the British Empire Games on August 7th. It was John Landy who established an early lead. Bannister had said his previous accomplishments meant nothing if he could not defeat Landy. Bannister steadily gained ground on the Australian. And then, in a classic moment, Landy would look for Bannister on the inside while Roger flew by on the outside, winning in 3:58.8 and enjoying still another magic moment.
The feeling of movement, the sense of power, the excitement of racing, these were all things which, to me, were a very great excitement and pleasure. So, to me, there was no question in my mind as to what kept me going. It was really the worry about what I would feel like when I had to stop it all.